start off a new journey. We are currently on our way to the hospital. I'm feeling a bit nervous. I'm cautious. Took some meds before. So I'm not sure if it's because I'm nervous or because of the meds. But I will keep you guys posted on how the first day has gone. The side effects was, even if I need to vlog day one, day two, day three, but I will keep you guys posted. So, yeah, let's do this. Sorry that I don't have so much energy. I'm just scared that I'm going to. How you feel, baby?
Nervous.
Feeling nervous.
A bit anxious about everything.
Anxious. But it is to feel anxious about. But yeah. I'm sure they'll explain everything to me and make me feel as comfortable as I can. And we'll just take it as it comes. I did pack in some snacks, guys, and my books. Things to keep me entertained. So let's hope for the best.
Don't know how, but you did it. Made a way. Standing here, not knowing how we'll get through this test. But holding on to faith, you know best. Nothing can catch you by surprise. You got this figured out.
Just going to my oncologist. And here we are.
Wrap within your arms and step in. And everything we need you to supply. You got this in control. And now we know.
Hello everybody, welcome back to our YouTube channel and for another update on my cancer journey. Thank you so much for all the wonderful wishes and support and messages of love that you poured out on our last video. I'm so overwhelmed by all the love and support that you guys have shown, and I'm truly blessed to have so many amazing people be part of this journey and part of my life. So guys, as you've seen, it's day 7 now after my first chemo session, and like you saw in the video, it was quite emotional. I don't even know where to start because I can't believe that I've made it through the first 5 days of chemo. They said it's going to be intense, and it was everything and more. So let's just start from where the video left off. So as you saw, when I got to the hospital, we spoke to my doctor, the oncologist, and she just went through the side effects with myself and Clyde again, just to explain to us what to expect after the first chemo session. And then we went down to the chemo room where everybody was attached to their drips. And that part for me was so scary because it's something you only see on the TV, in the movies, where there's so many people sitting in a room attached to their drip on these cozy lazy boy chairs. And each one getting their dose of drugs. And at that point I broke down because I couldn't believe that this is where I'm at in the journey now. I knew it would come, but I didn't know it would happen so fast. And it feels like, I always say that the one thing has to happen in order for the next big thing to come. And I feel like when I walked in there, I was just overwhelmed with everything. Okay, so when I got to the chemo room, I was introduced to the nurses. And because they saw how emotional I was, they were so, so supportive. They assured me that they will be part of this journey till the very end. There's nothing for me to worry about and that I'm in good hands. And that definitely helped a lot. Clyde was given the opportunity to be with me for a few minutes before he had to leave, because they're not allowed to stay with you due to COVID again. And when the tears stopped, I had to pull myself towards myself and said, we got to do this. They gave me a steroid injection to avoid any possible allergic reactions. And they also gave me pre-meds to prevent the nausea that's gonna come with the chemo and all of that. I went to the toilet a lot, which was quite annoying because I was attached to the drip, which means it's tied to the pole. And whenever I had to go to the toilet, I had to push this pole along with me. Okay, so that was it. 6 hours later was a long sit. So today is 7 days later, and today is the first time that I'm actually feeling myself and up to doing this video. I know that I said that I'm going to record every day, that I said to myself that I'm going to record every day and journal how I'm feeling, but I was really unable to. The side effects really knocked me out, and yeah, I am, and I'm going to just update you guys on how the days actually went. I also thought that this video might be somewhat informative and encouraging to people that don't know what the process of cancer is really about behind the scenes, because you find out people have cancer but you don't know what they have to go through, like the step-by-step process to get to the point until they are obviously now cancer free. So I hope that this will also be educational in a way, informative and encouraging to somebody that's watching this. Okay, so let's get to the bottom of it. Day one after chemo, I felt like someone that was drunk, to be honest. I had to hold onto the walls when I go to the toilet. I did go to the toilet a lot. I also had diarrhea, which was hectic. That is one of the side effects. And my feet and my legs started feeling very sore. So from my knees down, my legs was extremely painful. My feet felt like I walked on coals, and the main thing after that stood out for me was the appetite change. So this drug will stay in my system for 20 days. On the 21st day, I have to go back for cycle 2. And this drug is so strong, it's a combination of two drugs, so strong that it will suppress my bone marrow and lower the red blood cells, which means I'll be more prone to infections. So you gotta stay away from me if you're sick, guys. And so I started feeling the side effects, like I said, the diarrhea, the sore legs. I also felt the appetite was the most hectic one, because I couldn't understand that it happened so soon. I know it's a side effect, but it's almost immediate, because I know Jesse made me a toasted cheese sandwich, and it felt like he threw so much salt on that sandwich, but everybody else said it tasted fine. So there I knew that something's wrong. I wanted fruits, specific fruits like pineapple and watermelon and those kind of things, but the taste was all salty. And they also say there will be like a metallic taste in your mouth, which I won't say I've experienced that, but I have seen that the lining of my gums and my mouth was almost like a whitish, like you have a fever. It was somewhat like that. And also noticed like some sores, like red spots in my gums and around my mouth. So that was very shocking to see that the side effects is kicking in almost immediately. The sore legs continued throughout the 5 days, but day three I think was my absolute worst day, where I could actually see when I look in the mirror that I'm sick, like I was pale, looking very anemic. My speech was almost sore, because it almost sore, yes, in a way that it was painful to speak. I had so much fatigue and nausea. The nausea is one of the biggest side effects. They do give you tablets to control the nausea. Like I said, they give you pre-meds, but they also give you medicine and tablets to take home to prevent the nausea. But it's a nausea that it doesn't mean you throw up. It's a feeling of nausea that's constantly there and it doesn't go away. So you kind of have that spitty taste, like you want to spit, and also almost think to yourself, let me rather just put my finger in my mouth and rather throw up than wanting to think, is it going to happen or is it not going to happen? That's the worst feeling of it all. My feet continue to be painful, like there was a tingly sensation in my fingertips, and that is something they have spoke to us about that might happen. But guys, I felt so, so, so sick. I didn't know that this is really how chemo is going to feel. I've been through many operations, prepared myself mentally. But I think laying there in pain on day three, I really felt like like, I can't do this. I felt like this pain is too much for me to handle. This pain, I can't push through. I'm not strong enough to be able to take this on. And to think that there will be more side effects, hair loss will come, I'll lose my hair, my eyebrows, and things like that at a later stage. But just to think that this is only the first few days of having this drug in my system, and it's already affecting me so much, I'm really dreading going back for round 2 and round 3 and round 4. Because I can't picture myself going through this all the time. I really feel, I've spoken to Clyde last night and I said that I can't do this anymore. I feel... Like, everybody says that I'm strong and they admire the strength that I have, but it's really, really difficult. I found that this is the mental fight. This is a big mental fight. Like, you feel like you, this is now where you feel like you have cancer, and you feel that the side effects is really that bad, that it's too much for one person to handle. Like, you want to share the pain with somebody, you want them to take some of it away for you, but it's obviously a battle that you have to face on your own, and a challenge or a test that you have to go through on your own so that I can come out strong in the end. But guys, I really didn't know that chemo is going to hit me this hard. I can't be in a moving car because I feel like I'm going to throw up. I felt like a small child because between my family, they've decided to who's going to look after me, so that there's always somebody around me. And I had to pack my bags and be transported to my sister them to sleep there, so which means I'm not at home with Clyde and Jesse, because Jesse has school the next day and I can't be alone at home. And then transported back home again, so that, because somebody will be there to look after me the next day. Because this is obviously something that's so unpredictable. You don't know what's going to happen next. So you have to have somebody around you to obviously take care of you, to make sure that you eat, make sure that you take your tablets and things like that. Because I couldn't help myself. I did feel helpless, I must admit. So, like I said, today is the first day that I'm able to sit and actually tell you guys about what has gone on. In the car, I had to take a packet with me in case I threw up. The bumps in the road, everything felt like it's hurting me. And like I said before, my pain tolerance is quite high. But when a pain like this, or like a feeling that you can't do anything for yourself, comes over you, you kind of feel helpless, you feel weak, you feel sick. And every time, like I said, I went to the bathroom, I looked pale, I looked like somebody that... It's just too much. And the mental battle that you have to fight is really something that I don't understand how other people make it. And I have to go through this another 3 times and radiation. And it just feels like it's a lot. So, yeah, I need to pull myself towards myself now. That is what the past few days have felt like. It was a lot of tears. I sometimes look across to Clyde and him looking at me, and the tears was there because this battle has now started of us having to push through the last hurdle so that I can be better and so that I can come out okay at the end. So it's not something I can turn my back on now and say I don't want to do this, because I started this and I have to finish it. So yeah, I'm not sure if I'm forgetting anything. Am I forgetting anything?
I don't know if when I talk about the state operations happening next week.
Oh, I also, yeah, it was also our anniversary yesterday. on the 4th of Feb, and how ironic that the 4th of Feb now has been, is Cancer Day, which we never knew, and now it's almost like relevant to us on our anniversary. We couldn't go anywhere because of how I'm feeling in terms of the walking and the driving. So we just spent a nice, comfortable, relaxing day at home. Clyde was with me, so that was nice. And he made me breakfast, and we just spent the day together, which was really special and nice. And I also received my operating date for the stent to be removed, as I mentioned in the previous video. So they're looking at the 10th of February to remove the stent and to see if the stent has helped open the urethra channel. And like I said, if that has been successful, it cancels out another surgery. But if all has failed or it has been in vain, then I have to have another surgery where they have to cut me open and fix the bladder situation inside. So I'm not looking forward to that. I think that is one of the things that made me emotional last night when I spoke to Clyde. It's like, I don't want to go to hospital anymore. I'm tired of being attached to drips. They struggle to find veins. It's a whole thing. It's painful. My body is almost like it's shutting down because it doesn't want to, it doesn't want these needles in it anymore. And just the fact that I have to be away from my family, whether it's a day or two, whether it's 4 days a week, the fact that I've been in hospital so much, it's really, to me, it's boring now. It's tiring, it's draining. And I have to find the courage inside of me to keep pushing through because I know I'm almost at the end. But because of your prayers, like I said, on the days that I can't make it and the days that I feel that it's getting too much, it's the prayers of all of you guys that is hope, that I'm, that's giving me hope and giving me strength. Because like we know, God's strength is made perfect in our weakness. And I can see that, and I can feel that because of the prayers of the people, I'm able to make it. So I want to ask you guys to continue to pray for me. This journey is still long. By the time I'm done with this and hopefully done with everything, it will be half of the year already. So much has gone into the healing of this whole journey. I feel like life is going on around me and I'm always just getting better and must go to hospital for the next thing. It's putting a lot of things on hold for me, things that I've planned to do with my life. But I believe that God has a plan. Like I said, in my waiting, God is still working. And through the tears, God understands what it's about. So yeah, I hope I'm not forgetting anything. They said that you also get chemo brain, where you forget things. So I'm blaming everything on that nowadays when I want to make a joke. So if I've missed out anything, I will add it again. They have given me an information pack when I came to hospital the first time, so that I can read up about the type of drugs they're giving me for my cancer. Also the side effects. So at the end of all of this, I will be an expert in terms of what cancer is all about, guys. And yeah, I'll keep you guys posted as the side effects continue. I will try to make videos and keep you guys posted. But thank you so much again for all the love. The messages that was pouring out after the video was amazing to see and hear how many people are praying for me near and far. And the fact that I'm receiving so much love and kindness is beyond this. I don't have words to express how grateful I am. So thank you so much for being with me on this journey. I will continue to keep you guys posted. Stay safe and God bless. Bye.